comes to improving mobile phone reception using mobile repeaters, there's a good way of doing it and there's a bad way. Doing it the bad way, things can get ugly fast. The good way of doing it is to contact your carrier to discuss the problem. They have solutions to boost your reception that work effectively with mobile networks.
Coverage and good reception are incredibly important to mobile users. They're incredibly important to the industry as well, who have invested billions of dollars to give you good coverage and good reception. But if you're in an area that's challenging, you can talk to your carrier about the use of a repeater. But the important message here is, don't go it alone, talk to your carrier and get good advice on what works for your situation.
Did you know that it is illegal to use an unlicensed mobile repeater in Australia? Even though you can purchase these units from seemingly Australian websites, they are not legal devices. There are unscrupulous suppliers selling unauthorised mobile repeaters under many different trading names and using deceptive, misleading, and fraudulent sales tactics. Using one of these devices can land you in a lot of hot water. The best way to make sure your device is legal is to talk to your Australian service provider. The bad way is to do it yourself by installing a cheap repeater from an unscrupulous supplier. DIY jobs can interfere with network infrastructure and affect not only you, but your neighbours and other users. Beware of unscrupulous sellers using deceptive, misleading, and fraudulent sales tactics. Contact your carrier or service provider about improving mobile reception. The problem with cheap repeaters not authorised by your carrier is that they are crude devices that can cause call dropouts and prevent others from making calls, including to emergency services, by interfering with the network. Unscrupulous suppliers use the anonymity of the internet to provide misleading advice and sell dodgy equipment to unsuspecting consumers.
The quickest way to find out about deception or misleading claims is via customers. Customers frequently tell us what's going on. They frequently tell us that the claims being made are not being met. And of course, the advertising claims frequently involve offshore numbers. You can't talk to anybody local. And the devices themselves are cheap. They haven't been tested in this environment. So of course, their performance quickly translates into a complaint. The complaint will come to the industry via the carrier or to the ACMA or to the Telecommunications Industry Ombudsman. Invariably, these complaints identify the cause of the problem, which is the illegal repeater, which is not compatible with domestic networks in this country.
Don't be caught out. The consequences could be ugly. Installation or use of repeater devices by anyone without authority from your carrier is a criminal offence. If you're found guilty of using an unauthorised mobile phone repeater, you could be hit with a 2-year jail term per offence, or up to a $255,000 fine per offence for body corporates.
There are severe penalties for unlicensed use of mobile repeaters, including jail terms, very significant fines, and potentially the need to appear in court to explain to a coroner why someone couldn't call 000 in an emergency.
It's not only the government that can take action. Mobile carriers can also take you to the federal court to stop you using the repeater and recover damages for the interference caused to their network.
There are better ways to improve mobile reception. Investigate the legal options. Don't be misled. You should talk to your carrier and find out what the better options are to improve your mobile reception. Be aware that there are many unscrupulous sellers on the internet. Don't be misled.
Visit our website for more information.